tried both of these things, and I'm going to give you guys my honest review on it and what you should choose and what you should look out for. So let's get right into it. I got the sauce. I got the drip. I make the play.
I get the assist. Impossible. Guys, this is my first video. I know that in the video, I know that I have a pit stain. I know I say a lot. I know I say a lot. And I also know that I blink a lot, but please bear with me. Thank you. Okay, guys. So I would like to start something new. We will be having a quote at the beginning of each video. So the quote that we have today is by Amelia Earhart. And it says, "The most difficult thing is the decision to act, and the rest is merely tendency. Let me know down in the comments. All right, let's get started.
It is Miss Classy and Curvy. So welcome to my channel. This is for the entrepreneurs out there. I will be going my experience using G Suite and Zoho. What is it called? Zoho Mailer Lite. I'm gonna be going over that. As you guys know, I'm an entrepreneur. I own a hair company and a weight loss boutique. So I tried both of these things, and I'm going to give you guys my honest review on it and what you should choose and what you should look out for. So let's get right into it. So if you guys see me looking down, I like have my little paper or whatever that I wrote everything into. So basically the name of the email for Zoho is Zoho Mail, and the name for the G Suite is G, as we all know it. So with the $3 per month, if you pay annually, you can attach files up to 30 megabytes, as opposed to G Suite, where you can only upload 25 megabytes. That might be a game changer for some people that send over like large files. Like, for example, if you're a graphic designer and you're sending over people's logos and their branding templates and all this other stuff, then those are larger files. So you might want to look accordingly on how you send that information over. Okay, so for people like me that like to know when their emails have been read, when I had G Suite, I downloaded a mail tracker, which I paid $20 every 3 months to know when my emails have been read. So I would get an email that, oh, this person has read your email, this person has clicked your link, things like that. But now that I switched over to Zoho, I am paying $8 every month, and those $8 every month, it is on an app called MailSpring, which I downloaded onto my computer, but that's for all of my emails, not only one, like the mail tracker, the app that I had on my Chrome for the G Suite to know when my emails have been read. So that was $20 every 3 months, and that was only for one account, as opposed to MailSpring, which I can use for all of my accounts. And MailSpring is pretty nice. You can organize it the way you like. You can add in your signatures. They'll help you create a signature. And it was really, really easy to use. Another thing for, I mean, me, I'm really picky, and on my phone, when I hear a notification sound, I automatically know what app it is, and sometimes I even know who it's from. So I like to have those custom notification sounds for different things in my phone, and that is something that you can do in Zoho Mail, but that is something that you cannot do in the Gmail app. So that's something to keep up with. So one thing that was really bothersome for me with Zoho was the fact that with Zoho Mail, you cannot send out a bunch of marketing emails. With Gmail, you can because they don't care. But with Zoho Mail, you cannot, because Zoho Mail has something that's similar to MailChimp and MailerLite. So that's the reason why you cannot send out like marketing and promotion emails. So if you do that, they will block your account for like a couple of hours, and then they'll unlock it. They have done that to me. But they also do have a separate space, that part of Zoho. It is free, up to 2,000 subscribers and up to 12,000 emails for free. You can do as much marketing as you want over there, but you just cannot do it in your Zoho Mail app. Okay, and this place where you can basically do like MailChimp and MailerLite is called Zoho Campaigns. So I know this video was a little all over the place, but if you guys have any questions, you guys can definitely comment down below and I'll answer your questions, because I know this, it was a little confusing for me as well. But so that's the difference between Gmail and Zoho. Zoho their cheapest option for your email. So let's say, for example, your company name is Bad and Bougie Bundles. So it's badandbougiebundles.com. So if you want to have info or support at badandbougiebundles.com as your email address, you can go to Zoho and pay $12 for the year. But if you decide to go, with G Suite, you will be paying $6 per month. So what you would pay for 2 months with G Suite is what you would pay for 1 year with Zoho. So definitely keep that in mind. And Zoho has different options. You can upgrade a $1 per month plan that you have to pay yearly. So it's like $12. They also have a $3 plan, which is what I was talking about, the Zoho Workplace. And they also have like a Zoho Premium or something like that, which is $4 a month. So personally for me, I have two businesses and each businesses have two sets of emails. So that's four emails. So for four emails, I paid $48 for the entire year. But granted, I am paying $8 a month for a MailSpring to get the red notifications. So we can technically say that's 4 plus 8. So that's $12 every month that I am paying. So I'm technically paying $12 every month for email hosting, as opposed to if I had those four emails with G Suite, I would have been paying 6 times 4, which is $24. So that's double, plus the $20 that I was paying every 3 months. So if you wanted to pay every month, I believe it was $10. So $10 times 4, which would be $40, on top of the $24, which would be like about $60 that I would be paying with G Suite. So I'm saving a crap load of money by going with Zoho, and I actually like it. It's really nice. I like logging onto my computer and I'll get like the notifications like, oh, this person read your email, this person clicked your link, and it'll tell you in real time how many times people have opened your emails. You'd be shocked at how many times people open your email, like the email that you sent them, after you guys have closed out the conversation. It's very weird. Like sometimes I'll get notifications, so and so open this email 12 times in like 2 minutes, and I'm like, what are you looking for? But yeah, so I definitely do like Zoho Mail. And for all the beginning entrepreneurs out there, I highly suggest that you go with Zoho Mail as opposed to going with G Suite, because Zoho Mail is cheaper and it's easier, and it's just lighter on the pockets. It's very, very light on the pockets, okay? So if you guys have any questions, let me know down below. And if you guys would like a tutorial on how I connect my domain name to my Zoho, then definitely comment that down below and I'll definitely make that video. Okay, bye guys. I got the sauce. I got the drip. I make the plan.